sailing on the kind of the edge of disaster, and one false move and it spells trouble. You either break a gear or you injure someone. And especially from my standpoint as skipper, it's always I have to have a little bit of a tempering influence on the crew. You know, when they really go for it, you have to say sometimes pull back a bit. We're not here to play safe. We're here to take calculated risks, and that's what it's all about in the Whitbread race.
Second yacht into Punta is Drum England, who, after her disastrous start to the race, suffering from serious hull damage, is suddenly coming good.
After the hard times we had on the first and second leg, didn't do very well on the second leg, and we had some damage on the first leg. On the third leg, we did very well. We came second, and we had a very good sail. We sailed tactically very smart, and I think it's because of the good tactics and good crew work we came ahead. A good morale booster for us, something we're going to need for the last leg.
Simon, how was the trip?
Fantastic. I mean, it was amazing. It's been such a long way. We've had big waves, we've had little waves, we've had a lot of wind, we've had no wind, we've had whales, we've had dolphins, we've got the amazing crew on board, and
what about, did you compose any new song during the trip?
No. Maybe later. But thank you to everybody in Uruguay for coming to see us in and make us feel welcome here. This is a fantastic day in my life.
Everybody eats the same, they sleep the same and work the same, and that's the way it's always been planned, and that's how Simon has always wanted it. I mean, he's trying to do the Whitbread experience as a crew member, and that's to do it, you have to do it full on.